Okay, this quick video here is just to introduce you to what I'm going to be starting to do on Meerkat shortly. On Meerkat, I've been doing a few live streams of video games, some Let's Plays on through Meerkat and that, which was pretty good. I tried doing it through Periscope originally, but I apparently got no viewers whatsoever. Well, I got like maybe one or two viewers at max on Periscope and that, but through Meerkat, I had like much more success with Let's Plays through Meerkat, so I'll be using Meerkat for Let's Plays. Unfortunately, Meerkat for Android has some bugs, so unfortunately, sometimes the stream cuts out, and there's some problems there. But yeah, this video here is just to introduce you to what games I'll probably be going through later today. I already posted this already onto my Twitter account. Is I'll be going through this very rare game here. I don't know. For some reason, I think the video is backwards. I don't know why. It's very strange. Anyways, this game is Xenoblade Chronicles. If you go online, eBay or various websites, you'll see this game is costing like about sometimes like $100, $200 just for like a brand new or even used copies are going for quite a bit of money. Luckily, I got this game right when the day it came out, so I have a copy of it and I'm never gonna lose this. So to show you its actual game here. This game was recently released also on the 3DS, but this is the full Wii version of the game, so I'll be doing Let's Plays on this for sure. Since this is actually a very phenomenal game, I recommend it to anybody who has a 3DS right now to go out and pick up the Xenoblade Chronicles 3D and Xenoblade Chronicles X for Wii U is coming out hopefully very, very shortly. I think it's coming out this year, I think, so I'm probably gonna pick up that game when it comes out as well too. Anyways, to keep this video short, let's go to the next game we'll be going through. The next one here, another one also on the from the project, sort of Operation, was it Operation Rainfall or was it the other one? I can't remember. There was like two different ones, one from Majora's Mask and one for like the other RPGs. This one's Pandora's Tower. Not as good as Xenoblade Chronicles or the next one I'm going to show you, but it's an alright game. I'm not going to do as many Let's Plays on this one because this one's not. It has some good scenes, but it's definitely not a phenomenal game, I gotta say. Sad, because Exceed did this one. Exceed usually does pretty good RPG games, but this one. I don't know, the gameplay is a bit, it's not really my style, I guess. It's not a good, not a bad game. Anyways, the next one here is The Last Story, a very awesome game, actually. This game I'm kind of stuck somewhere actually right now, so I'll probably be doing this one again from the beginning once the newer Let's Play. So if you guys want to be able to watch this game in action, The Last Story, do check it out. It's actually a pretty good game. I think this game you can still get for decent prices anywhere. So, and this is the collector editions. This one here has quite a bit of stuff inside. It comes with a art book and a few other goodies in there. And the box is quite nice. Looks like a book, so it's quite nice box art as well. So, and now down to the PS3 games we're doing Let's Plays for. I'll be doing preferably the Uncharted series. This is the Uncharted one here, but I have part two as well. Part two is still in the case. I beat this one before, but I've recently bought it again. So it's the Uncharted 2, but I'll be going through all the Uncharted games. I have Uncharted 3 as well, so I'll be going through these games. Another game here. This game is for this one. Some of these here are definitely mature audiences, so if you're going to live stream these, I'd recommend don't have any watch. Make sure your kids don't live stream some of these, because some of these games are pretty yeah, just careful with some of these ones. So Grand Theft Auto 4. I don't have 5 right now, but I'll probably get any 5 eventually. But Grand Theft Auto 4 is still a pretty good game. Another RPG game here, White Knight Chronicles 1 and 2. This game, this White Knight Chronicles 2 comes with part 1. I'm going through part 1 right now. I'm still near the beginning part. I'm probably not going to stream it from the very, very beginning unless you will request that. But I'll be streaming it right from my current save point, which is like still I'm in the desert part of the game. If you've ever played the game before, I don't want to make any spoilers from saying this, but I'm guessing these live streams are going to probably have lots of spoilers. So be sure you either don't care about spoilers or have played the game before or just curious about the game but don't think about playing it. I don't know. Some of these games have really good stories, so. I'm just putting it out there that there's going to be lots of spoilers on here. I have Infamous 1 and 2. This is just Infamous 1 box I have here, but I have part 2 as well. I'm going through part 1. I'm probably going to play this in the beginning again as the Infamous mode rather than the good guy mode. Right? I played through the good guy mode pretty far, but I think I want to try the bad guy mode soon because that mode sounds kind of cool. I'm going to pause the video for 1 second because my food needs to be taken out of the oven. 1 second. Can I pause? And I'm back. Okay. So next is another RPG game. This is one from Square Enix. I've been wanting to play this game for so long, and I've been playing through it pretty good. I'm probably not going to stream from the very beginning unless there's requests for it. This game is actually it's a pretty good game for the most part. I quite like it so far. The very beginning was very weird. I'm still trying to I think it's a post-apocalyptic type game, but when you play it, it's medieval. So yeah, you see remnants of an old world. It's actually really, really cool. Some of the styles and some of the stuff you see in the game is actually pretty neat. So I'm still in the fairly beginning stage of this game. I haven't been gotten too far yet, so still only near the beginning, so we didn't miss too much. Just the, I guess, the very first few scenes, I guess you might have missed in that, but yeah. I'm going to live stream this, and if there's requests, I can go back from the beginning as well. And then, of course, these ones here from David Cage. These ones are actually quite, good guys probably know what this, what these ones are, actually. Same David Cage, you guys probably know what these ones are. Heavy Rain, and then there's also Beyond Two Souls, which are actually pretty good games, depending if you guys like the kind of style of game, but I do. These games are quite fun. So I'll be going through those ones as well. I beat Heavy Rain, but I haven't beat Beyond Two Souls yet. I'm actually at, I was playing Beyond Two Souls, and now I'm at a part where I'm going into the laboratory part, which is, it's kind of eerie, and kind of the atmosphere is creepy, I guess. It's kind of good, though. It looks like kind of fun. And this game here is pretty popular by amongst a lot of PlayStation, fans. This one was on, this is a remix, remastered the PS2 versions of Ico and Shadow of Colossus. I'm not really good at Shadow of the Colossus as much at all. Like, I'm trying to get good at it, so if I live stream this, be prepared to see not a good player play this, but it's still kind of, still a fun game to watch, and it's kind of cool to see. Ico, I've been playing through, I actually quite like Ico. Ico is quite, it's quite a fascinating game, so. And then, this game I've already live streamed on Periscope, and I think Meerkat as well. This is a 3D Game Heroes, which is a very Zelda-esque style game. If you look at the thing, look at the graphics in the back there, you can see it's a good copy of Zelda. So this is already a rated E game as well here. So definitely, like this game is definitely for everyone to watch. It's a fun game. It's really cute. It's really cool. It's like, it reminds you of the old school Zelda. Plus the graphics are just so awesome. Like, I would love Nintendo if they just made remade the original Zelda in this style. Like, they really have to work at Silicon Knights and try and release a Zelda style in this mode. I tweeted this actually before, a while back. But you never know. Like, Nintendo has worked with Silicon Knights before for Bravely Default, and I think a few other games as well. If you look at the Wikipedia page for Silicon Knights games, you'll see a few games that were released in very recent years onto the 3DS, but nothing onto the home console. So, but hopefully Nintendo might work with them one day and release a Zelda game. And then finally, this game is rated M, and this game is very interesting. I won't be live streaming this during the day specifically. Well, during the day, you know, it's mountain time, so hopefully no one in Europe, hopefully there's no kids in Europe that are, you know, because time zone differences, but this game is rated M, and this game is very adult, but very fun. It's called this game called Christine, and basically there's this guy that's running through a nightmare for a long time. As you can tell, the cover art is very provocative in that, and the game is quite provocative itself. It has like movie sections in between each section. They're actually pretty well done. And this game here is from Altus as well. So Altus, I have quite a few Atlas games here. So but this game is, I didn't realize, 1 to 2 players locally. How does that work? Oh, yeah. Didn't know that until that week. Apparently it's 1 to 2 players locally. Interesting. So I'll be live streaming this at some points as well too. Right now I'm actually at quite a difficult part, unfortunately, so I'm kind of stuck there. I tried it a few times. I got so close, but then the baby got me. You'll understand what I mean if you ever watch the live stream. This game is just really, it's very bizarre. If you like bizarre games and like games that are very different or very Japanese, this game is definitely a really cool game to try out if you're a little mature and you're over 18, right? So that's the end of my introduction here, what I'm going to end up live streaming through at Meerkat. So hopefully if you guys are curious about any of the games there for any live streams, do follow me on Twitter, and follow me, I guess, on Meerkat if there's following on there. I'm not sure how that works. Meerkat will be showing the live streams when I do the live streams there. So my username on Meerkat there and Twitter is K, and then my last name, which is V as in Victor, E-R-O-N-E-A-U. So K-V-E-R-O-N-E-A-U. Just follow that user on Twitter or Meerkat, and I'll be posting this video here also to Twitter after it's uploaded to YouTube too, so you guys can watch this intro video here. And it's only about 10 minutes long, so it's not like it's gonna take too much time of your day to kind of see what I'm gonna be live streaming. As I pick up games, I'll have more games to live stream. I also have lots of retro games and lots of downloadable games that I haven't mentioned here, so that'll probably live stream at some point as well. So yeah, this will all be live streaming video games on Meerkat. Thanks for watching.